Okay, so you already know how to create an element. So how do you get from here to here? The answer is content. As it turns out, elements can go inside other elements. Content isn't just text, it is also other elements. So this is a new tag. It's a div, which means division. A division element, or we just call them divs, are used to group chunks of content together, and you'll be learning a lot more about divs later on. But either way, inside this div comes an H1 element. This H1 is a child of the div. Here, let me reorganize to make it a little bit clearer. I moved the H1 to its own row and I've tabbed it in. This makes it really clear that the H1 belongs to its parent div. You can see that the H1 comes between the opening and the closing div tags. You'll need to use this same format when you're writing HTML. Let me go ahead and add another element to the mix. Okay, pause for 1 second. What do you think the tree from this HTML looks like? What's the parent? What are the children? What are the siblings? Okay, I'm going to pause for a second and let you think. Here it is. You can see that the div is the parent of the H1 and the P, and that H1 and P are both siblings. So, just to be clear, this is the code that you write, and this is a way of thinking about it. As I keep saying, it's going to be really handy later on knowing that your code turns into this. Of course, as you're writing your code, the trees that you create with HTML can grow as wide or as deep as you need them to be. It doesn't matter.